Hey, everybody. It is 4:15 in the a.m.
Yep.
We are 10 hours in, baby.
I thought this is... No, this is hour 11, though. It's hour 11, but we are 10 hours
in. We have our biggest fan, I would say, on the phone, live from... What's your city again, Trisha?
Well, I am in the county of Northumberland, so
Northumberland. But you're in the UK for us Americans.
For us Americans.
You don't understand our geography.
Yeah.
So it's like 9 o'clock for me in the morning.
Yeah.
And 4 for you.
Yep, exactly. We're so happy to finally hear from you because you comment on a lot of our stuff. You've listened to us for a long time. And you've always been a big supporter of me personally, which I appreciate.
Yeah.
You listen to Atlas Avenue Beat, right?
I listen to Atlas Avenue Beat, Paralyzed Story, Across America.
And now Alter Ego, yeah. I've got you on too, right?
Alter Ego. Yeah, and Will There Be Cake?
Oh, wow.
There's not a lot of cake. Disappointed at the fact that I don't see pictures of cake every single day. Like,
that's true.
We actually just dropped a new logo for Will There Be Cake. Did you see that?
I did.
Yeah. just yesterday.
Yeah,
technically,
we've got new logos for literally everything, which are going to be dropping for throughout the 24-hour podcast.
You've already done a couple, though.
We've already done Atlas. We've done the actual new Seven Lamb logo too.
Do you like them?
I do.
Okay.
You do.
I do like the whole new style. Like it's the last ones are quite cartoony and like drawn, and these ones are quite like sharp
professional.
And
professional.
Yeah. We went with this company called K's Media, who we have a good friend that works with them, and he was very willing to help us out and get us a new look and reshape everything, which I think has turned out very, very well.
We have End of All Hope and a new Paralyzed one that we're going to debut soon within this 24 hours.
Yeah. But I have important questions to ask you, Trisha. Are you ready?
Yes.
You are? Mentally?
Yes.
This is something we've been asking every guest who's been on this podcast
yeah.
so far.
Did you catch any of the live streams that were on as well?
Yes, I've watched them all. Okay. I know what's coming.
Oh, she knows what's coming. Okay. All right. Very good. Okay, so I don't have to explain to you how it works, right? You got it at this point.
Think so.
Have you been working on your answers?
Yeah, like... Because some people wish they had some time.
Yeah,
to think
everybody's
about
like,
them.
Oh, I wish I knew. Well, you are prepared. All right.
Yeah.
So I'll start
when
with.
I did it and it asked Megan. I was like, oh, I like that answer. Oh, I like that answer. And then I'm like, all the good answers are taken.
No.
What am I going to do now?
We can have duplicates.
No, yeah, we've had some.
We've had plenty of duplicates, as I'm sure you've heard. So we'll start at the top of the list as we do with everybody. How about color?
Purple.
Purple.
Okay, so purple is now tied with red, I think.
I think it is, too.
So red and purple are the
purple's
two.
Purple's been picked 4 times. I think red's been picked 4 times. Or maybe it's 3.
It's close. Yeah, it's 3 or 4.
Forgive the cat.
It's, yeah, the cat's like digging in the litter
box
right now.
The cat's having a shite in the background.
it's fine.
So month for you.
October.
Ooh.
Okay. October's
I was going to say December for you.
That was your guess for her?
That was my guess for Trisha.
Okay. But you're wrong.
I'm wrong.
Okay.
I've been wrong with all the women in my life
yeah.
on this show.
That's true.
Let's see.
You remember?
I do. Animal.
Fox.
Fox.
Someone else said fox, right?
Jennifer said fox.
Okay.
Which is a good answer. Why fox?
Yeah, I was just going to say, why fox?
Fox is my favorite animal because it's not as domestic as a cat or a dog. But it's not as wild as like a tiger or a bear, so it's kind of in the middle. So like you do have the wild side, but you don't have the like the complete wild side. Like you can sort of love a fox.
I kind of picture you as a mama bear with 4 kids. I just imagine that.
Foxes
personally.
Can have kids.
Yeah, I know that, but there's no you know saying or you know mantra of a mama fox. But either way, it's a good answer.
And the reasoning works too.
Yeah,
I didn't have reasoning.
Makes
I didn't
a lot
have
of sense.
Reasoning for mine.
You don't have reasoning for a sea lion?
For my sea lion, except that it's a dog in water.
Okay. Not unlike a Labrador, but okay.
No, that's a real dog in water.
Yeah. Oh my God. Food.
Yeah.
Food that describes you.
Cheesy chips.
Cheesy chips.
Wait, what are cheesy chips?
It's right. Okay. So chips for us is your fries. So like
right.
It's
right.
Fries, like cooked potato in strips and then just melted cheese on top. But it's got to be like mozzarella or like a white cheddar.
We call that cheese fries.
Yeah.
Cheesy chips. We were talking about that earlier with food. Our friend Nello was on the show, and he owns an Italian restaurant. And I was talking about everywhere I go, if they've got a staple dish, I've got to go there and try that in its location, where it's from, to see what the big deal is. For instance, you know, if I went to Italy, I'd have to have spaghetti and meatballs. Yeah. So if I came to visit you guys out there, what's the dish that I have to try?
You have to go to a seafront and you have to have proper fish and chips fish on the beach.
Yeah. I figured as much. On the beach, even.
On the beach. You got to see the water. You got to know where it comes from.
Yeah. Like, you can't get it from anywhere where you can't see the water. You have to go somewhere like Amble Harbor, sea houses. They're like right on the, like literally, like you come out of the fish shop and you see the ocean. Mm. New Biggin, where I used to live, that's just down the road. You like, you come out the chip shop and you can see the ocean. Like, you have to go somewhere where you, like, you literally, you walk out and you're like, I see sea.
Yeah.
And you know exactly where those fries came from.
So there's a movie, I don't know how popular it is over there, but it was relatively popular over here when it came out. I imagined it was popular there. Snatch. Did you ever see the movie Snatch?
Yes, I have seen Snatch.
So
how accurate.
So you saying that to me reminds me of a quote where he's talking about how it's Dennis Farina. He's cousin Avi. Mm-hmm. And he doesn't want to go to London, and he's telling them, I don't want to go anywhere outside of New York unless it's to a sandy beach with little straw hats. Right. And Doug the Head says, well, we've got sandy beaches. And he goes, so who the fuck wants to see them? So, and then you're like, you've got to see it where you're on the beach and seeing the ocean. Is Dennis Farina just being a jerk? Do you guys have really nice beaches up there?
We do, yeah.
Ooh.
But it's got to be, like, it's cold, though, right?
Well,
like,
Dennis Farina is a big listener of the show, I know he didn't write the line, but...
Right. No. Don't hate on him.
Don't hate on
Dennis Farina.
Yeah.
But you guys, swimming. Do you do, a lot of swimming out there? Probably not.
Yes and no. We do, every Boxing Day, there's a thing at New Biggin Beach where you run into the North Sea. It's called the Boxing Day Dip. And loads of people do it.
When you say Boxing Day, what is that? What's Boxing Day?
The day after Christmas.
Yeah, it's like Canada does that too, right? The Boxing Day. Yeah. It's like Black Friday kind of thing, right? Maybe not.
We've adopted that from you as well, so we have that as well.
Okay.
But nice. We don't have Thanksgiving, so we do
you
Halloween.
You guys don't have Thanksgiving, huh?
Yeah, that Christmas, makes sense.
Then Boxing Day, then New Year.
Do you have an equivalent of Thanksgiving over there? Like, you know, a Founder's Day?
A giving thanks?
No.
Nothing? Okay. You're like, we're the original. We don't have to found shit. Yeah. But I've gotten a little distracted here. Did food. Last one, movie.
Oh. This is the one that I can't think of. I would probably go House Bunny.
House Bunny. That's Anna Faris, right?
Yes, it is.
Yes.
Anna Faris. The playmate. Or,
curious Playboy. Why that movie?
Yeah.
Because basically everyone just goes off looks, and it's more about personality. So you have to kind of come out in your own self, and you find different people who can help you do that. And they might be the most of unlikeliest of people. For example, a Playboy bunny helping a group of sorority girls.
Right.
Yeah.
So don't judge a book by its cover.
Yeah.
Pretty much, yeah.
Yeah, I like that.
And I know Jack doesn't like this one, but I really want to know, what's your favorite song?
You don't have to answer that.
Please answer it.
I'm tied for two.
Okay.
Shut Up and Smile by Bowling for Soup and One Less Heartbreak by Patton Pendon.
Bowling for Soup. That's good.
Yeah.
I don't know the other one. But I know Bowling for Soup has my cat.
Your cat's about to walk on the soundboard.
Yeah, please don't shut everything off.
And the cat was about to hang up on you.
Turn everything off.
Walk all over the keyboard.
Just stop the podcast.
Yeah. Anyway,
I'm guessing he doesn't like my choice of song then.
I think that's what it was. Yeah, he's must not be. A bowling,
you said
for,
bowling
soup,
for soup.
Yeah,
and the cat looked over here like, what?
It's like, no thanks. I don't even know what a equivalent.
So I'm curious. I the first time you commented on something for us for Seven Lamb, anytime people comment or like or follow the show or something like that, I always look at their profile to see.
You want to know,
are they friends of Rob's?
Oh, okay.
Are they friends?
I thought you wanted to judge them for like who's liking our stuff.
No. Not like that. I always want to think, do you know somebody or did you like organically find the show? And you were the first person when I looked at your comment and then I saw where you lived and I said, holy shit, this person doesn't even live in the United States, Rob.
Yeah.
And you would comment a lot of stuff. I just am curious, how did you find us?
You guys are my first podcast listens, so you got that one.
And whoa!
That gave me, that made me all tingly inside.
Wow.
So what it was I was having trouble sleeping, and I was like, right, okay, I need to find something to fall asleep to. Mm-hmm. So I was like, I don't want to listen to, like, the generic go to sleep, you're tired, or Sounds of the Ocean or whatever. I was like, right, okay, let's go find a story. So I literally just typed in story into the search podcast thing on Apple Music, and I was like, oh, story, cool, click
oh,
that
shit.
One.
Nice. Oh, right.
So you listen to the dramatization of Mark.
Stop saying, my name is Robert. You've known me for years.
Yeah, it's really interesting at this point. My friend Mark, who I do Atlas... oh my God. Dude. I do alter ego with.
Jesus Christ.
It's getting early.
It's
be
late.
Quiet.
It's late for us.
Late and early. And I every time I look at Rob, I'm like, yeah, right, Mark? I don't know why. They look nothing alike. Sound nothing alike. In my brain, though, your cat is going to cause
gonna
trouble.
I'm
going to
keep talking. I'm going to go kick my cat out of this room.
Yeah. But so I was just surprised. So story is the first one that you listen to. And I play John in that one, who in the dramatization, John is Mark. Oh my God, is Robert walking across the country? What'd you think of that one?
I actually really liked it. I was like, okay, I really got into it. And then, you know how before every podcast, Rob like does the thing like, we also have this and this and this. I was like, okay, I'll listen to Across America. And when they caught up, I think Across America surpassed story. And I was like, oh my God, I know what's coming. How's he going to dramatize this? How's he going to do this? Like, really into both of them. And I was like, okay.
Yeah, she said she started listening to Across America after Story, and so Across America got ahead of Story. She was like, oh, my God, how are they going to dramatize that?
Yeah.
So she went back and kept listening to it.
Yeah, that was a hard, like, I wanted to keep Story, like, pretty realistic. So, like, there are some times where it is just, like, you know, them talking and talking about different, and it, like, it was weird because sometimes I felt like it was too slow, but I'm like, but at least it's, like, pretty realistic to what I experienced.
Yeah.
Like, real time.
Do you prefer a story based in reality?
I don't know, because I really enjoyed Paralyzed. So
yeah,
did you, so you listened to the finale, did you like the finale of season 3?
Yes.
That you one did. Just came out.
We had somebody comment right before that dropped. And they were like, please, God, don't let this person survive.
This one character survive. And I'm like, ooh,
please,
I
don't let it be that
bad
person.
News.
And Rob and I both knew. We were like, you're not going to be happy.
Yikes. Oh, well.
But, yeah, it's good. It's good. And then we've got End of All Hope. You listen to End of All Hope?
No, not yet.
Oh, okay. Yeah, End of All Hope just, season 4. That's what
so
we're on, right?
It's funny. So we're mentioning End of All Hope right now. And in honor of Trisha, I think I'm going to go ahead and post the new End of All Hope logo.
No, do Paralyze instead.
Well, okay.
She
I wanted to drop
Paralyzed.
End of All Hope so she could be like, ooh, that one looks cool.
Okay.
I want to try
that's
that
true.
One.
Okay. You can do that one.
Because
we got the new logo for that one already.
We do. We have the new logos for all of them.
No, we don't. He's
which,
still working
which
on
one
a couple.
Don't we have?
Dude, we have like 10 podcasts we do.
That's true.
It's like... it's almost too many at this point.
Let me see all the ones we got. Oh, I've only got one more to do after this.
Yeah.
Actually, two more.
It's not a two more.
Yeah, I've got this one here that I can't speak out loud yet.
I can't see it. Oh, that one.
Yeah,
I got
that one. That one's and later. And this one for End of All Hope that I'm about to do.
You can post the End of All Hope one. I like it.
Yeah, me too.
New, solid. It's funny because the End of All Hope logo, it was like the older one that's still up right now is a picture from my walk across the country.
Yeah.
When I was in Wyoming.
Yeah.
With a storm in the background. I was like, ah, that looks kind of like apocalyptic. So that'll be the logo. But now we have an actual logo for it. And End of All Hope starts off, don't mind the bad acting. It gets better as it goes.
Wow.
I'm just saying. Some people complain about the bad acting, but I'm like, it gets
better. That's one that I'm in, Trisha. That's what he means. That was an indirect shot at me.
I'm looking right at you.
How bad I am.
No, I use a lot of my friends. We started it a long time ago, and you know, they got better as we went.
But that's the thing, though, with everything, like with TV series, you see like how the characters start to click together the further on it gets. And you can't expect a group of people to go into a TV series, a podcast or whatever, right at the beginning and be like, oh, yeah, we're good. We've got this. I know this exact character. I've been doing this for years, because they haven't.
Yeah. And that was the thing is with End of All Hope, I was using kind of like, while the people who voice a lot of the characters are in other podcasts, too, this End of All Hope was kind of their first one to really like act in. So to be the main characters, it took them a little bit to get into the characters. And because they were just friends of mine and I wasn't paying them anything to like voice these characters, it was like, just try acting, even though they weren't actors and never really wanted to be. But now they are, and they're still going strong.
Yeah, it's going well.
Yeah,
I'd say. And now here's an interesting tidbit that I wanted to say about End of All Hope, because you haven't listened to it. So since Rob and I started doing this together and me being involved, Paralyze is always the king.
Yeah.
Paralyze is the one that has
the most downloads.
Most activity, yeah. Most listens, most everything. And very recently, in the grand scheme of time, very recently, End of All Hope has overtaken that.
Yeah. It's the king now.
Yeah. End of All Hope is now the one with the most listens, the most downloads, the most everything. It has caught up to Paralyzed and surpassed it.
So much so that guy left a bad review for us that I posted on Facebook that said, 1 star, either get on with the podcast or take your shit down.
Yeah. What else did he say? Make room for the other shows?
Make room for the other shows. Like, we're holding people up.
Go
like
to the back of the line.
Unreal. Sorry, I'm trying my hardest, okay?
Yeah, there have been times where I've been like, man, I hope people like this character.
Right.
I think you have ESPN or something, because you're like, oh, I really like this character. I'm like, yeah. That's my girl.
Like Charlie in Paralyzed Season 2?
Charlie in Paralyzed was one that I had so much fun doing. I was really happy to be Charlie. He made me laugh. I thought he was an interesting character, and I didn't play him like somebody who was terrified.
Right.
I played him like somebody who everything that was coming his way, he was just kind of taking it for what it was.
Yeah.
And he never got really scared. He never got really, oh my God, we're in deep trouble here. But, you know, I really liked the way he was in a horror podcast. I didn't want to play somebody that was always terrified.
I try to really throw in some like different characters in Paralyzed. Yeah. That's why a lot of people do not like the Michelle character in season 3, which I totally understand.
She was
that was kind
that
of
way.
The point. Yeah, that was kind of the point. I didn't realize people were going to hate her that much, but I'm like, that's cool. It's fine.
I kind of like that people hate her that much.
Yeah, I mean,
I think that's kind of her persona. Like, she's like, I don't give a shit.
Yeah. Right,
and that's what people hate about it, because everyone's like, well, I wish that I could be like that, carefree, and actually say what I want to say to people. But she just, instead of being like the nice person about it, she's like, yeah, I just don't care. Like, I'm just going to tell you straight.
Yeah.
And that's why people hate her. But that's why I love her.
Oh, really? That's awesome. You're the first person to say that. Because we've gotten emails and texts, or not texts, but like messages on Facebook just saying they do not like
Please get rid of this character.
Yeah. So,
and to
like,
me,
sorry.
That's kind of like quicksand. The more people are going to be like, get rid of this person. I'm like, no, we like it now.
I will say just a little bit out of spite, I was like, I'm going to kind of keep her around. Yeah. just a little bit.
Yeah.
No, I've been, once Paralyzed season 3 ended, we've already started working on season 4. I've been writing season 4. So I really am looking forward to releasing the next season, because I think people did like, for the most part, they liked season 3.
Yeah.
Even if they didn't like that character. But I'm looking forward to season four and starting to do that one. But we really, story season two is probably the next thing that we work on.
Story season two is the one that we've talked about before.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh, that's
right. For specific reasons that I will not divulge on this podcast of why Trisha and I have talked about this character.
Right.
But it's going to be good. I'm excited for that one.
Because that one's going to be like an actual story where it's not like the first season was about my walk, but like this one's going to be like its own thing.
It's going to be a different, I think, a completely fabricated story.
Yeah.
As opposed to the first one, which is very based in reality. If this second story was based in reality, I'd be worried.
Maybe for somebody.
Yeah. Like there are questions that need to be answered.
Right. What would you say is your favorite podcast that we do?
Probably Atlas.
Oh, really?
Okay. Why is that?
I just, you can't expect anything with it. Like literally, like I was sitting there, I was listening, I was like, okay, what's going to happen? And then I was like,
right.
What? You did what now?
Yeah, that one takes some left turns.
Season three is going to be, we have two episodes that released already.
Yeah.
And it's a longer season. It's 15 episodes with a super long finale also.
We're actually, we have still to record my lines for the finale.
The finale we got to do.
Which is the only thing we're missing.
But the finale, I don't know why I do that to myself. Like where it's 100 so pages and I'm just like, yeah, this is good.
Yeah.
Yeah, solid 100 pages.
We've even recorded the epilogue to it.
Yeah, before the finale.
Yeah.
Every one of the finales just keeps getting longer that I write. Like, eventually it's just going to be like a 500-page, like, essay.
Yeah. So, for me, my favorite character to record is Ambridge.
Oh,
because
for
he's
End of All
just
Hope?
My voice.
Oh, yeah. Because Locke, you have to actually put on.
Everybody else that I do, I have to do a crazy voice for.
I do want to apologize for Atlas Season 3 because there's a lot of stuff going on.
Yeah, there is.
So it's going to be really crazy.
Locke isn't that hard for me. All I do is drop my voice like this, and here we go, James Locke, baby.
Yeah, that's a solid.
Yeah, it's not that hard.
That's true.
For him. But other ones, like anybody from Cop Doctors, undertaking.
So stupid.
Is a lot to do. And Paralyzed was actually pretty challenging, too, because both of my guys had subtle accents that I played.
Joel and Charlie. And you'll be playing a new character appearing in this next season.
Season four.
Yeah.
We've been talking about this character for a couple seasons. Yeah. Since after season two.
Yeah.
We were like, or at the tail end of season two, you're like, oh, by the way, this is a character that you're going to be playing. And I have been so amped for him to show up. And then he's kind of gotten
pushed back. I keep pushing
back,
because of the
importance and what he's going to be, which is going to be cool.
I do want to say, like, just from a listener point of view, I want to ask, would you rather wait, like, a longer time and get all the episodes, like, 1 week after another, or get them, like, months sooner and just listen to it every other week, like how we do it right now?
It's a tricky one because there's been like times where I've been like, oh my God, I have to have the next episode. And then it's like been like a while and I'm like, oh my God, they're making me wait. And then other times I'm like, okay, I appreciate what they're doing. And like, especially when you post like all the edit and stuff that you have to do and stuff like that. And I'm like, yeah, okay. It takes a while so I can sort of see both sides of it. And I'm like, really like, okay, I know I need to be patient and I need to wait for this because Rob's working hard.
Yeah.
And he's doing his job.
All of our editors work really hard. I mean, Rob's one of them, but we do have a lot of people who edit for us, a lot of people who voice act for us. And I've said this on the page before. I've said this on podcasts before, but a lot of people don't seem to understand, like, especially with these super, super long finales, 1 minute of audio editing typically averages an hour of time spent editing that 1 minute.
Yeah.
Exactly.
I edited that season three finale because I was like, I want it to sound a certain way, and I didn't want to like make the guy who's been editing for us like do it. I just felt bad. So I was like, I'll edit this one. And I got it down to about 50 hours or whatever it was, 60 hours. And I was just like, Jesus, I need to stop making them so long.
Yeah. I mean, but at the same time, it's gotten a lot of positive reviews.
But like our ultimate goal is to eventually have it where we can release weekly, like get to where, you know, we have a season and it comes out every week, like a lot of podcasts and stuff. But it is just hard with like how much.
If this was our 100%, 100%.
If this was
time,
our job. Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, of course. And that's the one I'd say if we get a consistent complaint from anybody, that's it. Where's the next show? Yeah. When's it coming out? Come on, I'm waiting. It's like, well, we all have jobs.
Yeah, we're trying.
We all do this in our spare time, and we all do this for free.
I will say, probably within the last year and a half, like whenever we kind of like really started like buckling down and working on this stuff, yeah. I'd say I have probably not worked on a podcast maybe 3 days out of that last year and a half. Every day I've worked on some aspect of the podcast, like every single day.
Yeah.
So like we try, but I think eventually we'll get to that point.
I agree.
Where we can at least weekly.
The more and more things go and, you know, as sponsors approach and stuff like that, it'll get better.
Yeah. We'll get there.
Yeah.
We'll
get there. And until then, we will appreciate our audience, such as yourself.
Our fans.
Yeah.
Well, I share you wherever I can and however I can. So, like, if you post something on Twitter and stuff, I usually retweet it, and same with Instagram and things like that. And I think I've tagged you in a few things on Facebook and stuff. So
that's awesome. Because we're really bad at the social media stuff. I mean, we're getting better. But
yeah,
I
try to respond
bad.
To almost everybody that comments on stuff.
Right.
But there are some platforms I just don't see. You know what I mean? But if we get comments or something like that on Instagram or yeah, little how the sausage is made. If you comment on social media or you message us or something like that, chances are I'm the one responding to you.
Yeah, yeah. I don't. I just.
Yeah.
I just. I don't know. Yeah. I try to, like, if I see it, but I'm not, like, constantly, like,
right.
checking or, like, if I'm writing that day, like, I'm trying to, like, stay away from my phone. Stuff like that. 100%. But. Yeah, I mean, we're trying to get better with the social media stuff. I know Amber takes care of the Will There Be Cake stuff now.
Right.
So I'm like, you post the pictures. I don't want to do it anymore.
I can tell because she puts hashtags and you don't.
I do put hashtags. I put hashtags on all the pictures. I put more hashtags than you guys do. You don't even put hashtags.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Let's
Take
see
a look
picture
at
you posted.
Ego.
You don't put a hashtag.
This today, during the 24-hour podcast, I certainly have not been.
Yeah,
under any
I told you.
Let's see, 7 lamb. Let's try to find the last one that I posted. Yeah, this one right here.
I guarantee it's not.
Oh, I do have podcasts, or I do have hashtags. Hashtag new setup, hashtag 24 hour, hashtag podcasting, hashtag 7 lamb, hashtag arcade, hashtag new logos, hashtag we will make it.
Actually, Amber didn't post a hashtag on the Shark Day one.
Unbelievable.
I'll have to talk to her about that.
Yep. Well,
that shit ain't gonna fly.
It's gonna be a difficult conversation, but it's gonna have to be had.
Honestly, let's just say that one of us is not gonna be hosting Will There Be Cake after that talk. Just
oh
kidding.
My goodness.
Do you when you listen to Will There Be Cake, do you just pick like a random day? Because we release one every day, so it's like a lot. But I didn't know if you like pick a certain one that you just listen to.
I listened, like, for the first month, I listened to, like, everything in that month, and then now I'm just like, okay.
Let me pick a day. Flip back and forth,
so, like, it'll pop up. I'm like, right, okay, I'll listen to that one now, because I've got, like, however long, and then I'm like, right, okay, I'll just jump back a few days and re-listen.
Yeah, there's so many of them. There's, like, it's
every
a lot.
Every day.
I don't even listen to them all, you know?
You know, little known fact, I don't listen to any of our stuff.
Yeah, because you're a bad friend.
Yep. I just can't stand hearing my own voice. So for a lot of stuff, I don't like hearing
you
my voice.
You weren't in season 3 of Paralyze.
I just play it in the background.
Okay.
At work.
Yeah, no,
I just leave it on mute.
You know what's... Yeah, okay. That's one way to do it, I guess. It gets us that
cool
download.
Cool story. I guess somebody died.
I will say that after, like, even when I'm not editing an episode, I send it to this guy who he's been editing for us, especially like almost all the podcasts now. He's been doing a lot of editing, and he'll send me like a version. I'll listen to the version. I'll send him any revisions. Then he'll send me that, the next version. I'll listen to that. Then I'll send him any more revisions, and then he'll send me like a final version, and I listen to that. So I listen to every episode like 3 times that by I'm like, I'm kind of sick of the episode at this point. like, ugh.
You know what's going to happen.
I wrote that. Come on. Jeez. Big plot hole there. That's my biggest worry now that people are actually paying attention to the stories.
Yeah, we did have somebody send us a long comment, and then after that, it was like, oh, they're really paying a lot of attention to the story.
I got to make sure I'm on top of this stuff.
Yeah.
Do you ever listen to your podcast and think, oh, I'm going to change it? I wish I'd said this. I wish I'd done that. Or do you right, okay, I've got this. I'm just sticking with it.
Well, okay, so I will say there, every time I write a script, because I write all the scripts, every time I write one, I'm like, that's I'm happy with it being done. But then I'm always I should change this. I should change this. But then I'm I can't keep doing it because we got to just release something.
Right.
And a lot of times it's more nitpicky stuff. Maybe just a line of dialogue that's just
Not to mention when he's sitting there in the studio when we're recording it, a lot of times, me personally, I don't know if anybody else does this, I'll read a line and if I think it sounds better a different way, just saying something differently.
Character, yeah.
Yeah. I'll say it differently. I'll obviously say one line. Typically when you come into the studio, we want you to say every single line 3 times.
Yeah.
We want you to read
different inflections.
That's right. Yeah. Different inflections. If you want to add something, one of them's always got to be straight from what it says on the
page.
Because
everybody records separately.
Yeah.
Which is very hard to line up dialogue when you're not really bouncing off of anybody.
Right.
So to line up everybody's dialogue, you have to make sure you have the right inflection. So sometimes I feel like there are parts of the podcast where it kind of sounds a little off because of the way somebody's saying a line. But I'm I'm not going to get them back in the studio for one line to fix. I'll just try to make it
And down the road, if we have a studio set up where there's actually a studio and we can do, not actually a studio, but you know what I mean.
No, go ahead. Make fun of our studio shit, Jack. Just say it.
For our studio, 2 people standing in and recording is unrealistic.
Yeah.
So if we ever got to a place where 2 people could record off of each other, I'm sure that would sound great. But scheduling would be a nightmare then.
Scheduling is just hard because everybody works day jobs and it's hard to get everybody in here. But I will say from a writing standpoint, I think my writing has gotten better over time. So I'm not as judgmental on myself. I do cringe with some of the early stuff. I'm like, why'd I write that in there?
My favorite is the lady who reached out to us on Twitter with a threat.
Oh my God.
If you don't change this one thing, I'll just be forced to not listen anymore.
Yeah.
And we both bit our tongues until they bled to not just go, then don't listen.
No one's forcing you.
Right. I mean, and she acted like she was doing us the biggest favor in the world by telling us of this quirk that she didn't like.
And it was about my writing.
It was about Rob's
writing. That was the first time that I got that.
Yeah. And it was really hard for me. Because as I said, if you talk to us on social media, chances are it's me. I had to bounce that off of Rob and be like, Rob, I'm going to tell this person that they can go listen to whatever the hell they want.
Well, it was funny because I think she was just starting to listen to either Paralyzed or the first season of End of All Hope or one of them. But it was the first season. She's like, if this doesn't change soon, I'm not listening anymore. And I'm like, well, since there's already 3 seasons out, it's probably not going to change anytime soon. So I'm very sorry because I'm not going back to fix that.
Exactly.
Listen, I'll admit, I try to proofread my stuff as best as possible, but it's really hard when you're trying to read what you wrote because sometimes I'll just fill in the words as I'm reading it and stuff. And I'm trying to make it natural.
And
with the dialogue.
And people are comparing these shows to other shows that they watch or listen to and some that have a really high production quality. And they don't understand.
That have proofreaders and have multiple writers.
And they have table reads before they go and do it. And they go over all the dialogue with a fine-tooth comb. And we have a person sitting at a computer writing a script.
Writing a script and then recording everybody separately and trying to match it all up. And I'm not really paying anybody. None of my close friends I'm really paying, so it's sorry.
I don't get paid for anything that I do.
No. But you get, I give you a hug every once in a while.
But I don't want
a high five.
I don't want that hug.
You said you like them.
Yeah, not when I'm sleeping.
Well, you shouldn't sleep over here then.
That's true.
Weirdo.
I guess, now we're going to just announce Trisha as the president of our UK fan club.
Yeah.
I've asked you before. I was like, are you talking about Seven Lamb over there in the UK?
Yeah. She's plugging her stuff.
I tell everyone.
That's so crazy to me.
That's awesome.
I'm like, Seven Lamb Productions? I don't want to listen to them now, do I? They're rubbish. I've got to listen to Will There Be Cake.
There's too many of them.
Yeah. How was that, Trish? Was that good?
No.
It's like, Irish. Very it's not offensive. Hers. Yeah. That's not, is it offensive? No. Did I offend you?
No.
No.
You can say yes. If it's
I would true. Have to. No, this is going to sound weird, and I don't think it's going to happen, but I would have to be over there and to really listening see to people here, yeah. and see their way that they speak. I bet you if I did, I could. It would take me 3 days, and I could do you a flawless Geordie accent.
Yeah, you're good with like the accents. I mean, you're going to have one soon.
Yeah.
Spoiler.
Accent.
Maybe
accent
not that city. Accent, but like a certain ass accent.
Trisha's
over
just
going
to be looking at her phone and shaking her head. No, like
that's wrong.
Terrible.
Yeah, that's wrong. They wouldn't say this.
Nope.
In fact, in Atlas Avenue Beat, there's like a Canadian character. And that's not easy either. Finding somebody they had who, like, we were trying to find someone who just could do a good Canadian accent. I can't do one.
Sure, eh?
I can't. That no way.
Yeah.
I'm not even gonna try.
Well, we've cast you as a character.
Yeah, so get on it. Start
you're
practicing.
You're just gonna have to learn.
I mean, yeah. Can you do a Canadian accent, Jack? Kind of a little
sure,
bit.
Sure. Okay. It's really not that different from United States.
It depends.
A couple of differences.
It's like weird because like Letterkenny. Isn't that that's Canadian, right?
Yeah.
And so is Schitt's Creek, isn't it?
Schitt's Creek is not.
I thought it takes place in Canada.
No, it doesn't.
I think it does. You want to make a bet?
No, I don't bet.
$100,000.
I don't bet ever.
But what if it's $100,000?
If it's a surefire bet?
Yeah.
No, I'm still not betting. I just don't bet. I'm not that kind of guy, you know what I mean?
No, I agree with you. I don't gamble or bet.
Schitt's Creek. I don't think that's Canada. Megan would know. She watches that show a lot.
It's a Canadian television show, though. Because Dan Levy and Eugene Levy are both Canadian. But they don't really have the accent. And I think, is Catherine O'Hara? I think she's Canadian, too. I don't know.
She drives me crazy, man. Her her accent in that, it is Canadian television. And it is set in Canada.
It doesn't say what town, though.
And it films in Ontario.
It films
the name
in
of the,
Ontario.
The name of the town is Schitt's Creek.
Well, I know, but I like, oh, so it films in Ontario. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. I guess that makes sense. That's weird.
Okay.
So they don't really like have like a thick accent or anything.
No, not really.
I don't know. Ryan
Reynolds
still won't try
Canadian.
To. I still, so is Justin Bieber, yeah. isn't he?
And they don't have.
So is, let's name all the Canadian people. Michael Myers.
Yeah.
Mike Myers. Not yeah. Michael Myers.
Seth Rogen is Canadian.
Brian Adams.
Jay Baruchel.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's it. I'm done.
Any other?
Brian Adams. And goodbye.
And see ya.
Yeah.
I'm out.
Yep.
Yeah. No. I can't really do any accent. I can do a really bad Italian accent.
Let's
that's
hear
probably,
it.
Probably offensive.
Let's hear it.
No, I did it on Atlas. I
should
was
have
the,
done it when Neil was here.
I did the kid, Italian kids in Atlas season one.
It's me, yeah.
Wow. Is that it?
Yeah. Oh, okay. I'm a little tired, so it's hard to really get it out there, but
it's a
you sound like Marvin the Martian.
Hello.
Yikes.
Earthlings.
You just add an A at the end of everything.
Actually sound like Kermit the Frog here.
It's a me, yeah. Marik.
Mario?
Wahoo! Yeah!
That's
Mario. Yeah.
Let's go! Now that is an Italian accent.
There you go. That's an Italian plumber.
Plumber.
Who is red,
sure.
white, and blue.
Da-da-da-da-da-da.
Yep. Can you tell we're tired, Trish?
Yes.
Yeah. She's like, oh, yeah, I can tell.
At least we're not singing yet.
Not yet.
I mean, we sang a little bit earlier.
It's 3 a.m.
It's 3 a.m. and I must be lonely.
Here we go.
Is that Mara? What's that from?
That's the boss theme from Super Mario 2.
Super Mario 2, that's what it was.
Here's this one. Everybody knows this
Everyone knows that one. That's a solid one.
You know this one, right, Trisha? Tell me you know this one, Trisha.
I think so.
Do you play games, Trisha?
I do.
Oh, nice.
She's a gamer.
What's your favorite game?
Of all time.
Of all time.
Of all time.
And not just since you've been alive, like, of all time.
Yeah.
So, like, you can go back to the 40s if Darts. You can think of, yeah. Polo.
My favorite shooter game would be Gears of War.
Hey! I love Gears of War.
Yeah, we were just talking about that.
I'm playing the crap out of Gears of War 5 right now.
Well, look at you.
Yep. I made a friend.
You got Gears of War 5. I've only played the first two.
Have you played Gears of War 5? Trisha?
Yes, I have all the gears.
Bingo. Same here. Did you cry when Dom died?
I did, yes. I bubbled my eyes out like a little bitch.
So
well,
did Jack.
You know what? I was telling that story right before we got you on here, actually. 2 hours ago, I think.
I don't know. It's all starting to blend together.
It's all starting to roll together. But you know what? You've unlocked an achievement, Trisha. You've lasted through the 4 o'clock hour with our nonsense and stupidity.
That's true. It's almost five now.
Yeah.
Damn.
Almost five in the morning.
We are like cruising. Honestly, this
11 hours.
So easy.
Oh, yeah.
It's so easy. I'm not even worried.
Me neither. Yeah. Especially because we have nobody for the next hour.
Oh, this next hour is going to be brutal.
You and me. Oh,
I can stay.
Hey, actually, if you want to, you're welcome to.
If you want to.
Do you want to take a break, right? Like just a 5-minute break?
Yeah, we'll take a quick break, save and export.
Yeah, because we like to save and export every hour just to make sure we don't lose it. And then we'll come back and then you can continue to join us if you want.
Yeah.
Yeah, sure.
Cool.
All right, cool. So let's do that. Let's end here.
So the weird way that time works is we will hear from Rob, Trisha, and I next week.
Unless you're listening on Patreon.
If you're listening on Patreon, you'll hear from us in the next 5 minutes.
Less than that.
Less than.
Yeah, probably like a second if you just go right into it.
Yeah.
Enjoy.
I just want that to be a mind fuck for people out there.
Oh, it's too confusing. All right, well, we will be back. This has been a Seven Lamb production.